Last fall, we had insulation added to our attic. I thought it would be worthwhile to see what kind of improvement in our heating bill this made, and share that with people who might be wondering the same thing. The insulation is blown-in cellulose, and the installer added 4 to 5 inches thickness over what was already existing. This was done on the top floor of our house, which is a tri-level. Our house is stick-built with 2x4 walls, having brick veneer on the first story and aluminum siding on the second. The walls have nominally R13 insulation. We live in Climate Zone 5, which stretches from New York City west to Nebraska. You can see in the other attic space on the lower level what the ceiling insulation used to look like. I know there's a lot of junk up here, but that's because I'm in the middle of some work in the attic. Our house was built in 1976, and the energy efficiency standards weren't what they are now. There's loose fiberglass insulation filling in between the 2x6 joists, and at one point the old owners added another layer of 3.5-inch thick fiberglass bats, the type you would use in a 2x4 wall. Figure the attic has an R value of maybe 28, though likely a lot less because the fiberglass was old and kind of packed down. The addition of the cellulose insulation adds about R18 to R22, so theoretically I'm at R46 to R50 in the upstairs attic. Anyway, let's take a look at the numbers and see how the heating was impacted. Since we have an ecobee thermostat, I have access to detailed thermostat data going back 15 months, so I'll download some data here. To give it a reasonably close comparison, I'm looking at data from December 2020 through February 2021 against the data from the same months a year later, after the insulation was installed. Before getting into the numbers, it's worth discussing how heat is transferred through an attic. This is very much simplified and ignores a lot of things like air leakage and convective heat loss, but it'll be good enough for talking purposes. The general equation for conductive heat loss through a surface is given on screen. The area A of the space has not changed, so that's a constant. The temperature difference, delta T, can be determined from the thermostat data. It's difficult to impossible to figure out the heat transfer coefficient, U, given all the confounding factors, but it's safe to say that this value has gone down with the addition of the new insulation. The operating assumption here is that the heat transfer, Q, is directly proportionate to the furnace runtime. That is to say, the more heat leaving the house, the more the furnace has to run to keep up. Since the ecobee app only allows data to be downloaded in 31-day long chunks, I had to combine the data from the 3 months into one sheet. I'm really only interested in three columns of data here: the outdoor temperature, the master bedroom temperature, and the furnace runtime. As such, I hide the columns with extraneous data. The first data point I want to find is the temperature difference, delta T, between the bedroom and the outside. To get an idea of the heat loss over time, I multiplied the temperature difference by the time step, which is 5 minutes for this data. I had to make some adjustments in my formula to account for the time rolling overnight, which has given me some negative values. Next, to sum the delta T minutes and the furnace runtime. I did this for both sets of data, then summarized each on this sheet for a comparison. The idea here is that the delta T minutes divided by the furnace runtime will give me a number representing the heating efficiency of my house. Comparing these two results from each year, it looks like adding the insulation provided about a 9% increase in heating efficiency year over year. To give an idea what this looks like in dollars, I downloaded some more data for my natural gas utility showing my therm usage per day. This usage isn't totally for the furnace, as our water heater and stove are both gas, but they use very little gas compared to the furnace. Summing the data over the last 3 months, we spent about $410 on gas heating the house. Assuming our efficiency increased 9%, that's a savings of about $39 over 3 months. This may not seem like a lot compared to the cost of the insulation, but bear in mind that the insulation will also reduce our cooling bills in the summer, and the benefits will continue to accrue through the life of the house. There's undoubtedly a lot more we could do to help with heat loss, like sealing for air leaks, and that sort of thing. However, I'd say this was a success. I know this was a very simplified analysis of the heat transfer through my attic, but I think it's good enough to illustrate the difference that the insulation made. Anyway, I hope this is helpful if you're thinking of adding some insulation to your attic. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.